Hey everyone, so I am doing a cookie cutter pour, and so I don't think the seal is very good. I can see like some space, which means I think the paint is gonna probably come out pretty quickly. So I'm gonna find something that I can kind of weight these down with just a little bit. And then I have these colors that I'm working with. So I have a Tuscan red, a melted chocolate, a burnt umber, a khaki, a tropic orange that I kind of think is like a coral, and then a antique copper. So all of these colors, I figured I wanted to try to keep something with the browns, and I've never tried browns before. So we're gonna see how well this works. Let me get you guys hooked up into here. Boom, look at that. Okay. So let's find, I'm going to use my cutting board that I got that I'm also going to paint later. I'm going to use that once I get some paint in to kind of, oh, here we go. Let's just do it this way. To get it to sit that way I can still pour into it. It's just not going to, pop up. Hopefully we'll see how well it works. I don't know, but I'm going to use white as well, and I did not put silicone into my white. I usually don't, so just kind of a rule of thumb, if you guys are gonna start doing these paintings, I personally do not use silicone in the white, and the reason being is because one of the paints has to be heavy enough to sit. So I just kind of choose my white since I like to keep my paintings nice and bright, and then everything else has the silicone in from there. So this is going to be very interesting. Everything's going to look different because I have different parts of the gingerbread that I can pour in. So kind of curious what it's going to look like. Oh my goodness. The colors are going to be really cool though. Like I said though, I'm a little nervous about the brown. But I think by having these brighter colors in there, I think that's going to kind of help offset the negative appearance of the brown that a lot of people would normally see. So I'm not really gonna try to layer my brown as much. So we'll see what happens. And I did make it a little bit thicker, so that way it's a heavier color, which means it'll come underneath more than trying to peek through. So we'll see what happens. And you guys can see a little bit of what's going on. When I pour it in, it starts to connect and separate. Kind of does everything that you wouldn't normally expect paint to do. There we go. All right, this is the weird, ugly brown. The gingerbread brown. So we'll see what happens. I'm not so sure about it. And then the turtle, it's just there for a wait. Like I said, I didn't want the paint to all come out right away. So as soon as I lift the turtle, I'm assuming that a lot of this paint is actually gonna try to run away and come out. But what's cool about the gingerbread is I don't have to do just a single layer or just pour it in one spot, kind of spreading it around and making it do something different. So I think that every single one of these gingerbreads are gonna look completely different. We shall see. Pour some more red in here. I think I like the red. The red kind of helps offset the brown just a bit. Pour some more over here. Let's do some more metallic. Oh, see, the paint's starting to creep out already. So, we'll see. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add a little bit more white. Just, ooh, look what it's doing there. I'm gonna add a little bit more white just to hopefully have that help with the brown too. And we'll see what happens. And then once I take my turtle off, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna surround all my cookie cutters with white because I really don't want all of these to combine together. So white just kind of helps. We'll be right back. I'm extremely problematic when I go in there. I feel like I'm easy peasy. All I say is I want the powder, but apparently getting powder is not as easy as it seems. I've tried to go in twice now and said, I want powder, and I still somehow get gel, but I know nothing about nails. It's my sister's thing, so I'll leave her to do that because she's super awesome at it. Okay, so huge thing of white, just shaking it up a bit. And then, let's see, I guess I should probably mix it too, just in case. Sometimes the white likes to get a little chunky, so we'll see what happens. I have these nice long sticks that I like to use just to mix it up a bit and see if there's any chunks that I can kind of scoop out, which it doesn't look like there is, so should be good. Might even be a little too thick, actually. Let's see. Nope, perfect. Okay. Alright. Let's go ahead and put the lid back on. Pour it around. You guys can see I'm a very messy painter. I should wear gloves. I'm just so bad at it. More like lazy and forget to put them on. Either way. Okay. I'm going to try to get a little bit of that gingerbread appearance back in there by putting some of this white in the arm crease and the leg crease and the neck crease. So we'll see if that works. Pouring some white around here. White around here. And then once I get this around, since obviously that's a crap ton of paint, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, my spreader got lost in the way, I guess, so let me grab something else to spread it with. Okay, so I'm going to take just a popsicle stick, and I'm just going to spread some of this paint around, so that way it gets to all the corners. And then I used some cookie sheets with a cookie cutter painting. I just realized that. So cookie sheets with a cookie cutter painting. That way all the paint kind of falls through it. I normally use tacks, but they've been getting harder and harder to put in. I'm not going to accept the fact that I'm getting weaker, so we're going to avoid that conversation altogether. I'm not getting weaker. It's getting harder and harder. All right. So just spreading it out a bit, and then this is also going to help too. Boom. Got a lot of bubbles in there. I might need to take a torch to this. Look at all that paint. So much paint. I try not to waste too much, but we'll see what happens. Okay. So get that paint around. Throw the cookie strip cutter aside. And I'm a mess. Whatever. Okay, so I think they've sat long enough. I'm gonna go ahead and lift them up and release. Ready? How cute! It is like a tiny little cookie cutter. Little gingerbread man. Oh, you know what? Here. Print! Baby Ginger over here. Let's lift up Big Brother Ginger. We'll call this one Chase. Chase is second. Not pregnant though. Lift it. actually really cool looking. I'm just trying to get that corner. Spread this one out some more.